So I'm going to talk to you about perceptual motor skills. Now, everyone in this room performs perceptual motor skills every day. Whenever you use a complex combination of brain functions to take in information from your environment, make a decision, and execute an action, you're using perceptual motor skills. Now, in some domains, like the military, medicine, emergency services, and in sport as well, expert performers have to be able to perform these skills under intense pressure in tiny amounts of time. By studying these skills in those people, we can work out and learn about brain functions at their most spectacular. What my research does is apply theory from cognitive psychology in order to investigate how anxiety and contextual information will affect these skills at three different levels: perception, selection, and action. Seeing, thinking, and doing. Now, I'm sure you're all familiar with the experience of anxiety. When I talk about contextual information, I'm talking about non-visual sources of information which help you understand situations. So for a doctor, it might be the medical history of their patient. For a sports person, it might be the score or the time left in a game. And what I did in my research was use some eye tracking technology on cricketers to show that anxiety will negatively affect performance of skills by actually making our eyes move differently here at the perceptual level. Your eyes will move more erratically. And that's not ideal when you're trying to intercept a fast-moving object or execute a tiny movement in surgery, for example. It also showed that changing the amount of information available to people also changes the way you actually execute a movement. And then what I did after that was decide I wanted to get a bit more into this selection part of it and how people perform under really extreme time constraints. So that baseball batter there, if he's going to hit a fastball, he has to be watching the pitcher, making a decision and starting his movement before the ball's even left the pitcher's hand in order to actually have time to hit it. We know people use visual cues, so different parts of the body, to pick up information, but we didn't know how people use their knowledge or past knowledge of a situation or the context around a situation to learn how to anticipate. What I showed is that a skilled cricket batsman can integrate what he's currently seeing with a lot of different sources of information from the past, knowledge of what the bowler's done before, someone he's seen before, the score of the game, field placings, almost effortlessly to develop really accurate anticipation skills. So they know where it's going to go almost exactly even before the ball's in the air. What this research does is allow us to design training environments for our athletes and for other people who need to perform these skills under high pressure in short times, like a firefighter, a medical professional. We design these training environments to include anxiety, context, and help teach people how to use these things, perform under pressure, save more lives, score more runs. Thank you.